Well, Stanford remains perfect at Maples Pavilion, but it wasn't easy. They needed overtime tonight to outlast Dartmouth 89-78 with Don McLean. Roxy Bernstein with you. And Don, Dartmouth led for over 30 minutes of this game.
Yeah, and we talked about Stanford not being sharp defensively, but let's give Dartmouth some credit. They came in with a great game plan. They attacked early. They got back cuts. They got things at the rim, and that opened up the perimeter for them. The scouting report on them was that they were going to get up a lot of threes. Not as many as we thought, but in the first half, they were making them 7-12 in that first half from behind the line. Got them the lead at halftime.
And Dartmouth got 22 from Torres Samuels, 20 for Brendan Berry. And Harrison Ingram was quiet for the majority of the night, but he was at the final 2 minutes in overtime.
I think if he doesn't make that three, we don't even go to overtime. But he was big down the stretch. This is the play they drew up out of a timeout to get it tied, to get into overtime. And I said it all night, he's the best freshman in the conference. I didn't see anything that would lead me to believe that he's not. And he got him to overtime, and then Angel kind of finished Dartmouth off in overtime. They did that high-low a couple times. He got out in transition, and it wasn't close in the final, in the overtime. A good win for Stanford based on the circumstances, but I'm sure a lot of good film to look at for Jared Haas and his staff.
Career high 18 for Brandon Angel, 8 coming in overtime. Also, Jaden Dallaire tied a career high with 22 for Stanford, and James Keefe was a factor early. He had a career high 12 for Stanford.
Yeah, good balanced effort from Stanford tonight offensively.
So the Cardinal 6-0 at home. They've won 23 straight against non-conference opponents at Maples Pavilion, unranked non-conference opponents, and 25 consecutive wins over Ivy League teams. For Don McLean, Roxy Bernstein, in overtime, Stanford 89, Dartmouth 78.